Good afternoon, here is Nicolo. In this video we will see how to use mFront. So mFront is a code generation tool dedicated to material knowledge. It's open source and it's available from the TFL website. Specifically in this video I'm showing you how to compile an mFront code and how to run the mTest, and it's specifically applied for the crystal plasticity model. So first of all, a prerequisite for this video is that you have installed and learned how to use Salomé Mecha 2019, and this is in a previous video made by me, which is called Install and Use Salomé Mecha 2019 on Ubuntu 20.04. Okay, so you have to watch this video first if you want to follow this one. So I'm gonna try a test in this particular folder. So in the last video I installed in the project folder, I made a folder called Salomé Mecha 2019, and I have created these two folder, Apply and V2019. These are the two folder which contain the Salomé Mecha installation. And today I'm gonna work inside a folder which I created. It's empty, so it's test simu.mat video. Okay, this is my working folder where I will put the code and then create my mTest file. Okay, so first of all, following this instruction which I will provide you, the very first thing is to find the mFront code for crystal plasticity. This is already present in the Salomé Mecha installation, so you need to go to this path. So Salomé Mecha, then V2019 tools, code aster, stable, share aster, tests, and monocrystal CFC. This one is the name of the model, so the mFront file where the crystal plasticity model is contained. Okay, so let's try to get there. V2019 tools, code aster, stable, share aster, tests. So this folder contain a lot of tests of the code aster. And if I search for CFC, it will find this one. So this one is the one I'm interested in. So it's called the monocrystal underscore CFC dot mFront. Okay. I copy it and I go back to my folder, test simu.mat video. I copy it here. So this file is dot mFront file and it contains the code. We will not go through the detail of this particular code, but I will just show you the main structure. So this one is there are this command which tell that is an implicit solver. Then there is the orthotropic behavior for the single crystal. It requires to introduce the stiffness tensor, as we will see later in the mTest. These are the material property that you will need to set. We don't describe them in detail, but we just use the standard value which are already in the mTest file, as we will see later. And then this is the code which take care of the crystal plasticity part, so the interaction matrices between the different slip system, calculation of the tangent operator, and then finally the integrator, which is the one which take care of the return mapping, which calculate the plastic part of the deformation. Okay. We will just use this in this video. We will not go through the detail of the code. So to use this code, first we need to compile it. Okay. And to compile it, we need to first load the Salomé environment. And what we do is go into this folder, Apply V2019. So So in the installation folder, there was this one created by the installation. Then we open a terminal here, okay? And we run ./ Salome shell, okay? This one load the environment. Loading the environment is important because at that point the mfront executable will be present. So if I do which mfront 3.2.1, yeah, this one is the name of the executable, and this one you see is the path to the executable. So if I do mfront and then I press tab, yeah, it suggests me the executable can be used. So now we go back and we go in the folder test cmu.mat video, which is the folder I'm using. You see the code is inside the monocrystal CFC. Okay. And then what you do is running the following command, which I copy and paste in the shell. So this command is mfront executable -- obuild. It means you are building the code, and then you need to specify -- interface equal to aster, because the target of my work is finally to link the mfront with aster. So you need to specify that your interface is aster, and then the name of the mfront file. Okay, so you execute this. It's gonna take some bit of time to compile. It gives some warning, but don't mind. At the end, it works anyway. And the most important line are this one. It tells you the following library has been built. So libaster behavior.so is the important one, because it's the one that will it's a library that link directly with CodeAster. And this one is also important. It's the name that you need to use for this material model. Okay. Specifically, if I go back to my folder where I'm working, you see, first there was only the code, now two folders are created, source and include. Okay. In the source, you can see libaster behavior.so. This one is the library that we can be linked with CodeAster, but at the moment we will not use this one because we just use the mtest. And then you can see the name. Aster monocrystal. This one is the name that is specified in the shell. So Aster monocrystal _CFC. You will need to use this name to specify that you are using this material model, because when you compile a code, there may be several material models. So both mtest and CodeAster don't know what to use if you don't specify it. So keep in mind this name. Okay. Now the code is compiled. We want to use it. To do this, we need to create an mtest file. Okay, an mtest file which works directly for this is not available in the Salome Mecha installation, but there is one which is very similar, and it's in this path. So Salome Mecha v2019, then prerequisite mfront share doc mfront test behavior. Bricks, finite strain single crystal. This folder contains some mtest file which are very similar to the one that we need. Therefore, I'm gonna copy it and show you how to modify. Okay. So let's go to that folder, Salome Mecha v2019 prerequisite mfront share doc mfront. Lost just 1 second. It's written here, and I'm gonna provide this to you. Then tests behaviors bricks, then finite strain single crystal. If you search this keyword, you will find it. Aster. Then there are these two which are very similar to what we need. So I copy one. So for instance, the one called the 0.12. I copy. And I copy it in my working folder, so test cmu.mat video. I rename this mtest, so I want to use the same name. as them front. This is not compulsory, but it's for clarity. So I put the same name, monocrystal underscore CFC dot mtest. Okay. Then I open this mtest and let's see what it contains. Now I will switch between this file and this other file because I already made a file that works, but I want to show you what are the modifications. There is some preamble, some comment that just you can change the name of the file here, specify that I am the author. Okay. So maximum number of substeps, this is related to the integration algorithm. You just leave one, and the same the linear prediction. Okay. Then this one are a constant that you can use, are defined at the beginning and can be used for the material property. They are the elastic property, like Young modulus, Poisson ratio. Okay, we leave them as they are. Okay, and then there is the behavior line. The behavior line must be changed. Okay, this one is not correct, and this one is the line where you need to specify the name of the material model. So this one must be changed into this one. So this one is just a comment that I wrote. The actual line is at behavior aster, okay, and then you need to point to the source libaster behavior.so, which is the library. So this file is the file in the source folder. It's this one, okay, is the library which contains the material behavior. And then you need to specify the name, because a library, as I said, can contain different material. So the material name is aster monocrystal underscore CFC, and it's the same that you got from the after compiling from the shell. So you see aster monocrystal underscore CFC. So you need to be sure that you save this one, because it's needed in the behavior line. So in the behavior line, there is first the path to the .so file, the library file, and second the material name. Okay. These are the material properties. So it's an orthotropic material, so you need to specify Young modulus in three direction, Poisson ratio in three direction, and shear modulus for three different type of shear. This one we leave the value as they are, so it's Young and no, so it's going to be 208 gigapascal, and the Poisson ratio is going to be 0.3. These other material parameters are related to the plasticity model. We are not going to change it. It's just the default value, which was already in the Salomon folder. So I leave this value as they are. Then there is external state variable temperature. It's just room temperature in Kelvin. I leave it as it is. Because the as I said, this M test is similar, but not exactly the same as the one needed for this material model. This elastic part of the deformation gradient does not exist in this particular M front model. So you just cancel this internal state variable. Okay. It's just not there. And then other modifications you need to do are related to the boundary condition. So you see in this original file, there is imposed deformation gradient, but the model monocrystal CFC is a small strain model. So this one you need to cancel them and substitute with a small strain boundary condition. The one I have ready are here. Okay, so I just copy and paste from my file and I'm gonna describe this one. So as you can see here, I'm doing at imposed strain EXX and then some number. So the meaning is that I am imposing a small strain value along the x-axis. Okay. And the numerical value, the meaning of the numerical value is the following. So there is a 0, colon 0, okay. This means at time 0, I want my strain along the x-axis to be 0. Okay. And then comma 10, colon 0.004. Okay. This means at time 10, I want my strain along the x-axis to be 0.004, which means it's 0.4%. In between these two times, a linear interpolation is assumed. So the strain will grow from from 0 to 0.004 going from time 0 to time 10. Okay. This is the only component I am imposing. If I am imposing only this component and not the other component, it means along y and z the boundary conditions are stress free. So it does not mean that along y and z the strain is zero, but it means that the boundary conditions are stress free. So there is no stress along y and z, and therefore there will be lateral expansion of, in this case, contraction, because I'm applying a tensile stress. The rotation matrix is the rotation matrix which applies to the crystal, so it describes the rotation of the crystal in the XYZ sample reference frame. It must be a rotation matrix, so you need to check that the transpons is the inverse. And in this case, there are some value. I was starting running the simulation with just the identity matrix. So I'm just substituting this one, and you see you can define the identity matrix 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. These two lines with add test, they don't work, so just cancel them. Okay. And then there is the time, which I described the time stepper. In this case, I'm using this one. Because it must be consistent with the strain that you impose. So let's look at the meaning. At times, I write 0, 10 in 2000. That means I want my M-test simulation to run from time 0 up to time 10 in 2000 time step. Okay. This means every time step will be 10 divided by 2000, okay? And it means it must be consistent with the strain, because I say they want my strain to grow from time 0 to time 10. Therefore, it is necessary that the time step go until 10. Otherwise, I will not reach my target strain. Okay, these are the modifications you need to do to the M-test. So this one is ready, and it will provide it to you. It will be provided to you in the instruction. And now I just run it. So I go back to my shell. I do list, and then you see you have mfront code, the source folder with the library, and the M-test file. So at this point, I just run M-test. You see, you get, if you tab it, you get the suggestion. Monocrystal dot mtest. So run it. Yeah, you see it's pretty quick, because it's mtest means this is a test on just one quadrature point, and it tells you execution succeeded, and you can see all the iteration. Okay, the time step was 0.005. And if you go in the folder now, there is another file produced, which is monocrystal underscore cfc dot res. This is the result file. Okay. If I open this result file, it is pretty much self-explanatory. There are a lot of comments at the beginning telling you the first column is time, the second column is the first component of the strain. First component means it's XX, and then second is YY, and third is ZZ, and the others are the shear strain. And the same for the stress. So the eighth column is the first component of the stress, which is XX. Let's look at what the number look like. So if you scroll down, you will see a lot of numbers. Just the first column you see is the time. It goes from 0 gradually. If you go to the very bottom, you will see total time is 10. And the first column, the second column is the strain. So the total strain along X is 0.004, which is the one we imposed. And you see the one along Y and Z are, they represent a lateral contraction. Then you have three components which are zero, basically, because they are the shear strain, which I did not impose. And then this column is the number 9, I think. No, it's the number 8. That's the stress along X. So if I want to understand what is the stress strain curve, I need to plot the second column and along the X-axis. and 8 columns along the y-axis. Okay, this value is 213 megapascal, and if I scroll back, you see it remains around 2013, yeah, doesn't change a lot. And then if I go back to the very beginning, then it decreases. You see now it's 198. Then I go back and it starts decreasing more quickly. 167, and then you go back to the beginning and it's going to be zero. So I assume you know how to deal with this column file, and I'm just showing you my plot that I did for the stress strain curve. So if you plot the stress as a function of the strain along the x-axis, you will get this stress strain curve, which is the correct curve. So you can check, and the elastic part is correct based on the Young modulus that we applied, and then there is plasticity, so there is yield behavior, and you can see there is also hardening behavior, and the stress reach about 213 megapascal. So therefore, in this video, I show you, in conclusion, I showed you how to use M-test and how to compile an M-front code specifically for crystal plasticity. And in the next video that I will make, I will show you how to link the library that I created with M-front together with a CodeAster simulation. Okay.